Hello students, how are you all? Hope everyone is fantastic and doing great, isn't it? Everyone by now, I guess, might have finished all the five main assignments that was given to you by the teachers in the month of March and April, right? I'm pretty sure that you might have kept even your summer assignments ready, isn't it? Lovely then, children. Then shall we now move on to lesson 5 of our maths, which is HCF and LCM. But before that, shall we go for a quick recap of lesson 4, that is factors and multiples? First, we need to know what a factor is. A number is said to be a factor of another number if it divides that particular number exactly. For example, 3 is a factor of 12, but 4 is not a factor of 17. Why? As it does not divide it completely. What is a multiple? A number that may be divided by another a certain number of times without a remainder is known to be a multiple. Now children, there are some properties of factors as well as multiples. The properties of factors are: 1 is a factor of every number. Every number is a factor of itself. The number of factors of a number is countable, that is finite, which we can count. Every factor of a number is less than or equal to the given number. Every factor is an exact divisor of the given number, and the number of factors of a given number is always even. Properties of multiples are: every number is a multiple of itself, every multiple of a number is greater than or equal to that number, and the number of multiples of a given number is finite. Now children, let us come to know about common factors. What are common factors? Common factors are the factors which are common to a given pair of numbers. And what are common multiples? Multiples which are common to a given pair of numbers are said to be common multiples. Now let us come to the chapter HCF and LCM, children. In this, we will be only dealing with HCF, and in the next class, we will come to LCM. Common factors, like I said just now, factors which are common to a given pair of numbers. Here, children, we have taken two examples. Suppose we have taken a pair of number like 24 and 18. So what we see here is the factors of 24 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12 and 24. And the factors of 18 are 1, 2, 3, 6, 9 and 18. Out of these factors, the factors which are common to both 24 and 18, you can see it in the elliptical shape, that is 1, 3, 2 and 6. So these 1, 2, 3 and 6 are said to be the common factors of 24 and 18. Now children, we can find prime factorization by two methods. To find the HCF, we need to do prime factorization. And in order to do prime factorization, we can follow two methods. One is the simple division method and the other is the factor tree method. In simple division method, it is like 36 when divided by 2, it is 2 18s are 36. Then the next step again, 2 9s are 18. Then 9 no more goes in the table of 2, so we come to 3. 3 3s are 9, and again 3 1s are 3. Then the factor 3 method, 36 we will find how much, what we will multiply to get 36. So either it is 4 into 9 36 or 9 into 4 36, the either way. So 4 again gets divided into 2 into 2, and 9 gets divided into 3 into 3. So the factors of factor tree method is 2 into 2 into 3 into 3, and in the simple division method where we did the prime factorization, there also it came 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. So the prime factorization by both the method, the answers or the factors come the very same. Common multiples, children, as we did just now or studied just now, multiples which are common to a given pair of numbers, they are said to be the common multiples. Let us take the example of, suppose the first 5 common multiples of 2 and 3. They are 6, 12, 18, 24 and 30. Now let us come to what a composite number is. A number which is having more than 2 factors Such a type of number is said to be a composite number. Now we also need to know, children, like for example 4, it is having more than 2 factors. 1, 2 and 4 are the factors of 4. 6, the factors of 6 is 1, 2, 3 and 6 itself. So it is having more than 2 factors, so it is said to be a composite number. Now what is a prime number? A prime number is a number that has got only 2 factors, that is 1 and itself. Like for example, take the numbers 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13. They are having only the factors. Suppose the factors of 2 is only 1 and the number itself 2. 3 also 1 and 3. 5, 1 and 5. So they are only having 1 as well as the number itself as its factors. Now let us come to HCF, that is highest common factor. Suppose we take 2 numbers, children, 12 and 18, and we need to find out the HCF of 12 and 18. You can see a diagram here where 2 circles are given and the elliptical portion is showing you the factors that is common to both the numbers, and then we go for finding out the factor that is the highest among these factors, common factors, that is said to be the HCF. Factors of 12 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. And the factors of 18 are 1, 2, 3, 6, 9 and 18. So out of these factors, the common to both 12 and 18 are 1, 2, 3 and 6. Out of 1, 2, 3 and 6, 6 is the number which is greatest. So the HCF of both 12 and 18 is 6. Again, we take a second example, children, where we take the numbers 15 and 30. Here, the common factors of 15 and 30 are 1, 3, 5 and 15. Out of this 1, 3, 5 and 15, 4 factors, 15 is the one having the greatest value or the greatest one. So the HCF of 15 and 30 is considered to be 15. The highest common factor of 2 numbers is the greatest number that divides both the numbers completely. Therefore, HCF is also known as greatest common divisor or GCD. Now we find HCF using the prime factorization method. The HCF of 2 numbers can be found by the method of prime factorization. This method is more systematic and easier as compared to the method of listing the factors. Let us discuss the method with an example and take the same example. Suppose we find out the HCF of 12 and 18. Factorize both the numbers into prime factors and write them as the product of their primes. So 12 is 2 into 2 into 3 and 18 is 2 into 3 into 3. Then in the second step, we find the common factors by encircling them. So what we do is 12 is 2 into 2 into 3 and 18 is 2 into 3 into 3. So the common in 12 and 18 is 2 and 3. Then we go for multiplying and finding the product of 2 into 3, that is 6. So the HCF of 12 and 18 is thus considered to be 6. Suppose we take another example, 15 and 30. So 15 is 3 into 5 and 30 is 2 into 3 into 5. So the common factors here are 3 and 5. So again we find the product 3 into 5, 15. Thus 15 is the highest common factor of the pair of numbers 15 and 30. Now children, this is all about how we find the HCF when 2 numbers are there or when a pair of numbers is there. If a question is given where we need to find out the HCF of 3 numbers, then what do we do? When we need to find out the HCF of 3 numbers, then suppose an example is given where we are taking out the HCF of 8, 12 and 36. The HCF of 8, 12 and 36 is 2 into 2, that is 4. Because here children, in 8, 12 and 36 only you see in the first step, 2 is common for all the 3 numbers. Again, in the second step, 2 is again common for all the 3 numbers. So it becomes 2 into 2 is 4. Therefore, the HCF of 8, 12 and 36 is 4. It is same as finding the HCF for a given pair of numbers. When it comes to 3 numbers, the method remains the same. Now we take another example where we are taking 3 numbers, 10, 30 and 45. Here, the only common factor for all these 3 numbers is 5. Therefore, the HCF of 10, 30 and 45 is 5. Now children, you will do exercise 5.1 and 5.2 in your maths notebook. And in the next class, then again, we will be discussing what is LCM or the lowest common multiple. Till then, bye-bye and take care.